And make it through another day there without dying. Politicians controlling our minds. Why we even voting for if they're making up our minds for us? Man, they must be thinking that we're blind, but they opened up our eyes for us. It's about time that we stand up, gotta move the line. What they didn't realize is they really just united us. Yeah, they use religion as disguise, but my God doesn't divide. This is something they can't hide from us.
We're delighted to have you back, and thanks for taking some of our viewer calls. Let me begin with the situation in Iran. The president's response, has it been appropriate enough?
No, it's not been enough. The president is having a full-blown press conference later on today. And I mean, no one could watch the film of the young woman, Neda, dying in the streets of Tehran without being deeply moved, so I would imagine and anticipate that the president will come out more today.
What advice would you give him?
To follow the example of our founding fathers, who declared that all of us are endowed with certain inalienable rights. Senator Webster, Daniel Webster, who when the Greeks rose up against the Turks in 1823, and I'd love to get you the full quote where he said, of course we have. It's our duty to stand up for people who are struggling for freedom. And Ronald Reagan, when he gave the evil empire speech, Nathan Shransky said that it spread through the Gulag like wildfire. After the Berlin Wall came down, people behind the then Iron Curtain said, you were our hope and our beacon. That's what America is. And it's interesting, of course, to see that the Prime Minister of England, the Chancellor of Germany, and the President of France have been far stronger in their comments. And let me clear up again, Steve. I'm not for sending arms. I'm not for interfering. I'm not for anything except for what we have done throughout our history, and that is lend our moral support to people who are literally sacrificing their lives for the fundamental belief that they ought to be able to peacefully disagree with their government without being... Iran is a great nation,
And the Iranian people are the stewards of a proud and accomplished civilization. Throughout their nation's history, Iranians have made spectacular contributions to the arts and sciences, to literature and learning. These achievements have not only benefited Iran, they have added to the development and enrichment of all mankind. And so it is with profound sadness that we think today of all the potential of the Iranian people that has been suppressed and squandered over the past 30 years by the rulers in Tehran. I know that the Iranian government is singing the praises of their revolution today. But Iranians are not fools. They know what the real legacy of the past 30 years is. Iranians know that the government in Tehran has ruined their nation's economy and kept them isolated from the promise of trading and engaging with the world. Iranians are right to ask how much better off they would be if all of the money, the billions and billions of dollars that Iran's rulers have spent sponsoring terrorist groups, tyrannizing their people, and building weapons to threaten the world were instead devoted to creating jobs, educating young people, and caring for the sick. Iranians are right to wonder why a country so blessed with natural resources cannot meet the basic needs of so many of its own citizens, and yet corrupt members of the ruling elite are stuffing the wealth of their nation into their own pockets. The rulers in Iran seized power 30 years ago, promising justice and better lives for all. But now, they throw innocent Iranians in prison without proper trials. They mistreat and torture Iranians in jail. And they beat and murder Iranians in the streets for trying to speak freely and exercise their basic human rights. The world watched in horror as Iran's rulers inflicted all of this abuse and more upon peaceful Iranian protesters after the flawed elections last June. But the world also watched in awe as courageous Iranians risked everything for freedom and justice. We Americans reflect with sympathy on Iran's continuing struggle for human dignity and human rights. Our country seeks a relationship of peace and prosperity with Iran, and it is incredibly unfortunate that the Iranian government seems determined to keep the relationship between our two countries mired in the past by funding and arming violent groups that threaten our citizens and our allies, by building a nuclear weapons program in violation of Iran's own agreements and multiple UN Security Council resolutions, and by spurning repeated American efforts to reach out respectfully to resolve our differences in peace. The United States of America has no eternal enemies. We can overcome even the most painful parts of our own history, as we're doing now with countries like Vietnam. So today, on this solemn anniversary of the hostage crisis in Iran, we honor our fellow Americans whose lives were forever altered by that tragic day. But we also look forward to a new day, a better day, when the long nightmare of the Iranian people is over and when our two nations share a relationship of mutual security, mutual respect, and mutual revenge.